Okay.
Well, yeah. All right. So I'm reading on this monitor. We're recording on this one.
All right. Here's three more paragraphs.
Very interesting and a little more revelatory on this subject of the Kabbalah, or the Kabbalists, the people who studied the Kabbalah. I'm seeing now that our YouTube correspondence refers to them as Kabbalists. So, more than likely, probably our YouTube correspondent is a Kabbalist. Now, keep in mind, although the Kabbalah was written in the code of the Hebrew, the Hebrew language, that is the same code written for the Old Testament, the Torah. The Torah is the first five books of the Old Testament. Okay, but the Torah is the Most High's word. The Kabbalist is some man's word, some man's knowledge, kind of like the knowledge of how to build a computer. Someone wrote a book about universal knowledge. All right? It's totally separate from the Bible, although it's written in the same language construct known as the Hebrew, the ancient Hebrew, and the letters, each letter of the Hebrew language contains within it a code, four level code for each letter, so that when we're reading the word, even the word itself, each letter has four things to think about at once. So if the word has five letters in it, you're thinking about 20 things at once going, wow! That's interesting. That sounds pretty cool. I wouldn't mind having a language like that. That would be able to do 20 things at once. That, cool, man. I'm all for that. That's why one day I want to be able to read the Hebrew and study it and check things out, but... Anyway, let's read this. Just so many layers that you are missing. Now he's speaking to me. If you are only reading in Greek or English, sorry to say, man, but so many layers. Kabbalah says again and again about the Torah. Not one word of this is about this world. It's entirely about the spiritual world. Okay, now what spiritual world are we talking about here? Are we talking about the spiritual world of the Kabbalists? Or are we talking about the spiritual world of the knowledge of the sin? So that the knowledge that we need to know revives our spirit. So that we can enter into eternal life. Because there's a fine line between the word spirit. Because the Kabbalists use the word spirit. They're spiritual things, talking about spiritual things, and they have a totally different definition for what the word spiritual means than what is defined under the knowledge of the sin, the gospel that Apostle Paul talks about. When he starts talking about spiritual things, he's talking about the things of the spirit, the knowledge of the sin, what Satan did, how he tricked Eve, how he tricked Adam and Eve. Children, the great mystery that the Gentiles would be grafted in to the Jewish branch, the knowledge that we don't have to obey the law no more. We're free from that. There's two new commands. These are the spiritual things that Apostle Paul defines versus the Kabbalist. He's talking about spiritual things in the encoded words that some man wrote, his own knowledge, or his own reflection of the universe, what he sees in the universe, and he calls it the Creator. The Creator has created this great universe. Ah, and there's supposed to be a consciousness that evolves in the mind that's called the spiritual world, the awakening of the four levels that allows us to become, as we'll find out that our writer says, to become perfect. Uh-oh, did he just use the word perfect? Well, maybe this isn't what he meant. But let's just read it for what it is. So it's on the record. On the record, there's my monitor over there, so my eyes are peeking over there. I want to say this tactfully, and I know I have said things that you will find difficult at first, or you may simply reject them. But you are missing and have been led to avoid part of what is inside of you, part of what Creator has given you. You are afraid of the Exodus and the desert before Israel. Parentheses, rejoining Creator. Now there's that word rejoining again that we talked about in the previous video. Your Exodus, quote, it's very understandable. It's the good and the bad. Kabbalists teach that the Moshiach, or Messiah, is in each one of us, awaiting the unveiling, which is an act of God. Because of our preparedness, which is partially achieved by knowing about the sin, as you do. There are several Kabbalists who have taught this throughout history and in different cultures. One of them you know very well. I need a reminder on that one. It's absolutely nothing to do with becoming like, replacing, being equal to the Creator. It's the inverse of why he allowed Eve to be tricked by Satan. Basically, we must burn our hand to learn not to burn our hand. Next paragraph. That's a smaller one. Religion's Jesus is basically everything you say he is, but Creator's Mashiach has been real, is real, is real, and will be real on earth again. Math, my mind, this conversation, any ability I have are tools to appreciate, enjoy, grow in, and thank Creator for the gift of creation that he has given us. Next paragraph. So much to discuss if you wanted, but I fear you'll think the worst of me now anyways. I don't know. Like I'm trying to convince you that Satan isn't real, when in fact I think he is real. But not in the way you do. But not in the way you do. Oh, anyway, we can reread that. Or that I'm trying to lead you away from Creator through trickery as Satan does, when in fact, a willful and highly publicized mistranslation of something is what tricks entire generations. A willful and highly publicized mistranslation of something is what tricks generations. All I can do is promise you that I wish to be unshattered. I wish to know you, to love you, to know and love Creator perfectly. But I can't. What? He can't. At least not until Creator fixes me. Oh? Oh?
what perfection are we talking about here? And are you fixed yet? Or are you just talking metaphorically? Interesting. Anyway, then there's the last paragraph. Enough ramblings and run-on sentences. Peace, mate. Hope you reply. All right. So, let's look at that last paragraph again. I'm beginning to see more and more the fallacy of this Kabbalistic way of thinking. And so my intuition was right on when I first started getting into this, because when I started reading his long messages, I was like, oh no, another long message to read. I'll just skim through it. But he did make some good points and helped me in a couple areas so far, and that's cool. He did help me to see that the Kabbalist, or the Kabbalah, does have sacred knowledge in it, but that the Freemasons have used that sacred knowledge to entrap humanity. So they use the Kabbalah book for evil purposes. But what he's saying is that a true Kabbalist will use the Kabbalah for good purposes. Now I'm starting to see that even those good purposes are heading right along with my intuition and from the knowledge that I've known, that even though this guy used the Torah code letters to write his Kabbalah, this Kabbalah is from these Kabbalah writings are mixing knowledge of the universe, mathematics, all right, patterns of the universe, mixing truth with lies, and that is the subtlety of Satan. I'm starting to see it very clearly now. Just like I figured right from the start. Everything on this planet, no matter what it is sprung from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Everything apart from the truth of the gospel, the one truth, the one simple truth of the New Testament. And the Old Testament giving us, you know, bits and pieces of the history. But the one simplicity of the truth of the gospel, the knowledge of the sin in the New Testament, that's all that's needed. All this other knowledge, everything, I'm telling you, everything. And I know, because I know the one truth, and I know that the one truth says everything that isn't of the truth is of the devil. And I know it so clearly. And now I see it in this aspect, this little book from the Tree of Life. Now I got a little more detail about a particular book that came from the Tree of Life, the Kabbalah. I'm not fully detailed on it, but from what this writer is telling me, I'm like, oh, okay. More knowledge from the Tree of Good and Evil. What's the knowledge of the Tree of Good and Evil? It has good knowledge and bad knowledge. And both those knowledges from that tree are both bad. Even though he took in some mathematics that has to do with the universe and the spirals and how there's patterns of the of the DNA molecules and all that. It's all followed after patterns and this and that. Although that stuff is just educated reality. Right?